गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई विल गिव एक्सरसाइज फ्रॉम चैप्टर 4. नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर 4 इज़ द मेटल्स एंड नॉन मेटल्स. फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन नंबर वन इज स्टेट 4 डिफरेंसेस बिटवीन मेटल्स एंड नॉन मेटल्स. स्टेट 4 डिफरेंसेस बिटवीन मेटल्स एंड नॉन मेटल्स. आंसर 1, रेफर टू पेज नंबर 49. क्वेश्चन 1 इज़ द स्टेट 4 डिफरेंसेस बिटवीन मेटल्स एंड नॉन मेटल्स. रेफर टू पेज नंबर 49. पेज नंबर 49 इट इज़ गिवन. यू हैव टू राइट फ्रॉम देयर डिफरेंसेस बिटवीन मेटल्स एंड नॉन मेटल्स. 5 डिफरेंसेस यू हैव टू राइट. राइट 5 डिफरेंसेस फ्रॉम द 1. सेकेंड क्वेश्चन इज़ द वायर्स cannot be drawn from material such as stone or wood. Why? Stone or wood are not ductile. Stone or wood are not ductile. Hence, no wires can be drawn from them. Hence, no wires can be drawn from them. What is the question? Question is the wires cannot be drawn from material such as stone or wood. Why? Answer is the stone or wood are not ductile. Hence, no wires can be drawn from them. Third question is the, what do you understand by the term metal activity series? Metals arranged in the form of table in the order of their decreasing chemical activity is called metal activity series. What is the metal activity series? Metals arranged in the form of table in the order of their decreasing chemical activity is called metal activity series. Next question is the, in this third one B, which metal among us the following can displaces hydrogen from acids? That is the zinc and magnesium. Now come to the question number 4. Question number 4 is the, describe all that you observe when a piece of sodium is dropped in water. So what will happen? Describe all that you observe when a piece of sodium is dropped in water. So answer 4 is the sodium floats on the surface of water. Sodium floats on the surface of water. Sodium darts about in the various directions on the surface of water, giving out tiny bubbles of a colorless gas. Sodium darts about in the various directions on the surface of water, giving out tiny bubbles of a colorless gas. And third point in this only, sodium metals gradually decreases in size and finally disappears. And in this only, point 4, the water becomes warm and is soapy to touch. In these four points you have to write. Sodium floats on the surface of water, and sodium, second point, sodium darts about in the various directions on the surface of water and giving out tiny bubbles of a colorless gas. And the third point, sodium's metal gradually decreases in size and finally disappears. And fourth point, the water becomes warm and is soapy to touch. Question number 5. Fifth A, what kind of oxide is formed when carbon is burnt in air or oxygen? It forms acid oxide, that is carbon dioxide gas. First answer is the, it forms acid oxide, that is carbon dioxide gas. Fifth B, what product is formed when the above oxide is dissolved in water? Carbon dioxide on dissolving water forms carbonic acid, carbon dioxide, that is the CO2. Formula of carbon dioxide is CO2. CO2 on dissolving, water forms carbonic acid. CO2 on dissolving or carbon dioxide on dissolving, water forms carbonic acid. And now come to the question number 6A. Describe all that you observe when a piece of iron is placed in copper sulfate solution for a few minutes. Question number A. A reddish brown layer of copper deposits on iron. A reddish brown layer of copper deposits on iron. A reddish brown layer of copper deposits on iron. Second point. The color of copper sulfate solution fades. The color of copper sulfate solution fades. Third point. The reaction mixture gets slightly warm. The reaction mixture gets slightly warm. In 6A, 3 points are there. This 3 points you have to write in copy. First point is the reddish brown layer of copper deposits on iron. Second point, the color of copper sulfate solution fades. And third point, the reaction mixture gets slightly warm. In 6B, question number 6B, what kind of chemical reaction takes place in 6A? Chemical displacement reaction takes place. Chemical displacement reaction takes place. Chemical displacement reaction takes place. And now come to the question number 7. Write equation for the following reactions. Equation is the aluminium and dilute hydrochloric acid. Aluminium react with dilute hydrochloric acid, then it forms 2AlCl3 plus 3S2 gas, hydrogen gas. Second point, zinc and sodium hydroxide solution. Sodium hydroxide solution. You can see Na2ZnO2 is formed and hydrogen gas is released. Then sulfur and concentrated nitric acid. This is the S. Sulfur and nitric acid. It forms 6NO2 plus H2SO4 plus 2S2O. And then fourth one. Sulfur dioxide gas and water, SO3 plus H2O, H2SO4, sulfuric acid will form. Fifth reaction, heated iron and steam. Heated iron and steam, 3Fe plus 4S2 steam, Fe, this is the F, Fe3O4 plus 4S2, Fe, this is the E, Fe3O4 plus 4H2, 3Fe plus 4S2 is steam, Fe3O4 plus 4H2. This is the 7th A, B, C, D, E, A, B, C, D, E, or 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And 8th question is the, why are sodium and potassium stored under kerosene oil? Why are sodium and potassium stored under kerosene oil? It is because they are highly reactive metals. It is because they are highly reactive metals. They catch fire in air or water. They are kept under kerosene oil. Again, you can see it is because they are highly reactive metals and they catch fire in air or water. They are kept under kerosene oil. They are kept under kerosene oil. Till 8th one you have to write in copy. Till 8th question I have given in this. Until 8th one you have to write in copy. And after completing question answer is necessary to write in copy. and others, I think all of you completed till match the following statements, and till here you have to write in copy.